Alright, so I've got a engine code PO300, which is a misfire. Could be coil, could be injector, could be a multitude of things. So we're gonna see what we can do here. Now I'm gonna do the old school trick, which is I'm gonna pull wires off and listen till one doesn't change, and hopefully I don't get electrocuted real good. It's not electrocuted, it's just jolted. The ohms on them babies suck when you get hit by them, but I'm gonna set you up here, and if it happens, you'll get to see a nice big hard jerk. But I will be putting on some gloves, though, you know, that don't really help, it's just for my head, for my mind. Let's fire this baby up. Now, it could also be partially running out of gas. I haven't put any gas in this except for like 5 gallons a long time ago. Well, look at that. I left the key on, too. That's not good. Oh, yep. Killed the battery. Ha! Can't believe I left the key on. Well, I guess I'll have to put the charger on it first. No change, just take your one off. I think I just found my bad injector. It's the number one cylinder. It's arcing, so my injector must be bad. See? Not. So, I believe my number one injector is bad. Or somehow come unplugged. And she's still plugged in. So, I believe my number one injector has gone bad. Means I'm gonna have to pull the fuel rail. That sucks. Guess I'll know what I'll be doing next. Either, well, I know it's I got sparks, so it's got to be the injector. The injector's got to be clogged or something. Happy day. I cleaned all them before I put them in, but these are the brakes. Number one injector. Let's change. You know, went in the house, ate dinner, said to myself, you know, it'd be stupid to only check 1 and 3 and not the rest of them, because it could be more than just one. So, let's check all of them. 5 and 7 time. Start her up. In here, it's missing like a mofo. So there we go. 5 isn't hitting. It's got spark, but it's not hitting. A 7's hitting. So 1 and 5, that's great. Go check 2, 4, and 6 over here. Yeah, it's 2's hitting pretty good. Nothing on 4. Six is hitting. And 8. So 1, 5. Let me turn it off, it's getting too hot. So 1, 5, and 4 are not hitting. That sucks. Makes no sense. I'm getting spark though. Put all these back on. Ow, that's hot. One, 5, and 4. Things are a pain to get on, especially with the boot on. And you know, the header's really hot. Okay. 1, 5, and 4. It makes no sense. Hot. Come on now. Come on, meow. Get on. Okay. So 1, 5, and 4. I'm going to pull off this injector plug right here. And I'm going to check and make sure that has power to it. Because maybe when I was fiddling around in here, put my computer in, I might have lost connection or something. I don't know. So I got some tools for that. Let me see if I can find them. Wait, stop right there. Please take a second to scroll on down and hit that subscribe button, maybe a little thumbs up like, and if there's anything interesting you liked about the video, why not comment, tell me good job, or say stay off of YouTube, I don't care, just help me out here, hit the button, like some of the other content, go check it out. If you're really feeling generous, go to the shop, you can get a shirt that's completely worn out. Not like this one, but you can get a good shirt over there at the shop. It's going to be at the end of the video. But please, like, share, and subscribe. So to test, I've got these Blue Point injector harness testers for TBI and injection. And wouldn't you know it, Multec 2. These are pretty old. I'm surprised it actually had the right injector tester on it. But now, let me fight one of these injectors out. Or not the injector, but the cord off of it. And we'll give it a test. See if it's hitting or not. If not, might have a computer problem, which will not be very good at all. But I'm gonna pull that baby out. Stabbing myself in the hand. I don't quite remember how that thing come off. one side clicks off. I see it. Picks are over here. Things are tiny. Alright. Now that should blink. If it's just a bad injector, it'll blink. Good. Let me check, flip it over. Make sure I ain't got that the wrong way. Is there a certain way? Okay, it clicked in that time. Check again. Well, that tells me that's got it. Okay, so three bad injectors. All of a sudden. Don't make any sense. I'm gonna start it back up now and see if it changed anything. And we'll go from there. Checking these other ones. Place is filling up with exhaust fumes. Going crazy up here now. Alright, let's do one. I didn't act like it was on there very good, but I ran fine before. So if the harnesses are all working, it leaves the one and only possibility of bad injectors, which is okay. I've got 8 more. If I can get this thing to go in there easy now. I don't wanna. There it is. Alright, let's check that one. One works and you fill them around. All right. That one worked. Might as well check the last one. You can do it. Back in your hole. one does not want to go back. Why not, right? There you go. Oh. Go on, you stupid thing. There it is. Okay. And might as well check the last one. You piece of crap. There it is. Alright. Last one. Let's see. Well, that's three bad injectors then. One, five, and four. I'm going to end up having to take that whole fuel injector rail off. Yay. Alright. Before I go through the process of pulling these injectors, injector rails and everything, I am going to swap in my speed density computer for my Caprice. Now, it ran perfect on this computer, but I wanted to run mass airflow and everything with the O2 sensors. So if this fixes the problem, that means that computer that I had just bought offline, that I had paid $70, 75, something like that, to have vats removed and, you know, set up the way I wanted it, is bad. And probably had it long enough to where I can't return it and get another one. Absolutely awesome. So, let me swap these real quick. I almost hope it's not it. So, no change. That's actually a good thing, because that means I didn't waste 75, 78, something like that, having that one tuned. And the guy I got it from, Preacher, which I got the motor and trans from, the computer he ordered for me is good. So, if you look right here, my fuse block is sitting face down and there's metal in that floor. Maybe it just popped a fuse. So, swap the computers back and I'm gonna test these fuses. So, after doing some research, only thing it can be is three bad injectors randomly. Now, I've talked to some people and asked some questions, and they all said the same thing. Sometimes when these engines sit for a while, which this one has sit for quite a while before I got it, I'm going to say at least a year and a half to 3 years. So, yeah, I'm going to have to pull them fuel injector rails and clean 1, 5, and 4, see if that fixes it. Because I think that's all it needs is just cleaned. Hopefully I don't have to replace them, but I do have 8 more that are questionable as they are. So, let's pull some injector rails. Hopefully don't get paint all over, or not paint, but gas all over my paint, and it strips it off and drives me freaking insane. But that's the name of the game. So, let's get started here. Thank you. be fun purge. You can tell those ain't been firing. No fire, no fuel, shall I say, no fuel? No fuel that dries a bone. So, let's see about cleaning them. Came off pretty easy. Yeah, drain out all your fuel. Wait, stop right there. Please take a second to scroll on down and hit that subscribe button. Maybe a little thumbs up like, and if there's anything interesting you liked about the video, why not comment, tell me good job, or say stay off of YouTube. I don't care, just help me out here. Hit the button, like some of the other content, go check it out. If you're really feeling generous, go to the shop. You can get a shirt that's completely worn out, not like this one, but you can get a good shirt over there at the shop. It's going to be at the end of the video. But please, like, share, and subscribe. Well, spilled gas out of the injector rails, pulling them injectors, which I got here. It's a butter bowl. Now, if you're from the South, these bowls are also known as your cereal bowls, your food leftover storage bowls, paint mixing bowls, parts cleaner bowls, and everything else. So, these are super ultimate multitasking tools. But, got my three bad injectors in here. I'm going to let them soak a little bit with three other injectors. So that way, you know, when I test them, if these don't squirt, I'll try the other ones. I got some B12 carb cleaner, which is like the only stuff to use, and some fuel injector cleaner concentrate, which is what's going to soak these. Let them soak for a while. We'll come back out here. Hopefully by then, the paint, yeah, that's how much that gas is affecting me already. Ugh. But we'll hopefully have the gas dried up, you know, into the mat. And these will be pretty much soaked. Alright, so I had cleaned another set, just in a bowl like that. The ones I had out, I was trying to make a... let me see if I can get it. Here it is. Tester with a syringe, you know how it does. You use your can of carb cleaner to, you know, give it pressure and just hit positive and negative on your battery or whatnot. It's supposed to spray. I couldn't get the test rig to work right. Could never get anything to come through, so I just said, you know what, screw it. Let's put in three different ones and try it. And that's where I'm at now. So, just got the fuel rail sitting there. Gotta hook it back up. Get it all ready to go. Which now would be the easiest time to actually connect these injectors. Maybe not. Why is that such a time with these plugs? Click. There's one. in there, Slim 4. Perfectly. Perfect. Easy, breezy, beautiful. Cover. In there. Let's push it on. Put this vent or this fuel regulator hook it back up. Run down these screws. Injectors. Throttle body. PCV came off. Get it back in its hole. The fuel lines. Let's see. It's top and bottom. You can do it. Come on. Where does that not want to go in there? I remember. I had the PCV vacuum and stuff between it, betwixt it. Oh, let me see how I can get that PCV back in now. Alright. So that should be everything hooked back up. Replace three injectors pretty freaking quick. Even though it's messing around half the time. let's see if she spews any fuel. That sounds like one of them injectors are stuck open. Nope, just now got there. All right. Alright, let's fire. Oh yeah. That's how she's supposed to sound. Now that's running on all eight. Yeah, I think that fixed it. Nice. Still hearing something though. What am I hearing? I don't know. It's probably just getting everything set back in good. Now let me back it out and see how it does. Them injectors did the trick. It's running fantastic again, not missing. Well, it feels like it does have a slight miss, and I'll tell you, I think it's probably one more of them bad, but I'll check it later. All the next stuff is getting this inner fender in. I already got that one in. Getting this one in. Making sure this don't hit. If I have to, I'll cut it down. Slide it up further, because I already made the bracket. Easy. Been running my headlights. I'm going to try to tuck them all over into the fender somewhere. Try to get them in there to where I ain't got to look at that mess of wiring. Put on my front clip. Well, not my front clip, my front end. Do the patina paint job to the outside. Put everything back together. Put the windshield in. Pull that window out. Put the new solid glass back window in, put that door panel on, mount all my computer and everything up under the dash, paint my dash, put my dashboard back in, and I can drive her again. Well, I mean, once I get the windshield in, I can drive her, but that's the only thing from being, like, done. Everything else is good. You know, I just pulled that out and remembered this tire over here goes flat. It's not flat, so we're good. It is leaning because my garage floor sort of leans downhill. No big deal, don't care. But we're almost at that point. I'll be able to get her down the road. In other words, yes, I am selling it. But it is now fixed again.